Time, Pink Floyd, featuring the amazing guitar work of David Gilmour. There's a few things to discuss about this, and the first thing I'd like to talk about is the tone. It's a pretty tall order to try to copy David Gilmour's tone exactly, but I wanted to try at least to get into the ballpark, so I did a little of this, and I'll tell you what it is. So I used an amp modeling program called Amplitude. Some of you may be familiar with it. And I pulled up an amp head that they call High Amp. And I think it's their version of a high watt head that Gilmour famously used. So I had that going on. And before that, though, I have a couple of effects. So first thing I have is a fuzz pedal, and it's pretty maxed out, and it's called Fuzz Age England, so maybe this is similar to something he might have used. And I also have a tape echo, the cabinets. So I've got a mic'd 412 cabinet on one side and a mic'd 410 open cabinet on the other side. In the rack, I've got a little bit of digital delay and a parametric EQ just to bring out some of the mids. So, I mean, altogether, get a little bit of that, and it's fine for now. Okay. The second thing I'd like to talk about is Gilmour's playing, his touch. Gilmour is one of the absolute masters of bending notes. And the way he has patience in bending his notes to coax them out just gradually like that, instead of like a quick, fast bend, he doesn't do that. He always is sort of milking the note just to get that sweet spot. And that's an amazing thing to learn about touch. The other thing I love that he does is his use of the bar, when he'll take a note and just sort of let it fade out into nothing. Again, patience with it instead of just whacking away, you know. It's again a really dynamic use of that. So we have those things, and the last thing I'd like to talk about is his approach to soloing over this song. We're talking about the first section today, so F sharp minor, A. That's the vamp. Okay, it's all about chord tones. That's the secret to playing the notes correctly. All right, so you have to know the notes, and these are just arpeggios. They're three-note triads. F-sharp minor, F-sharp, A, C-sharp, right? A, C-sharp, E. That's an A major. E, G-sharp, B is E major, okay? So the first thing, and we'll discuss how that's tied into the bending. So the first thing that we have is just the root note, vibrato F sharp, right? Now he's going to bend a B note up to C sharp. Let it down, right? So the C sharp is the fifth of F sharp, right? So you see how he's targeting that note, right? So. And then he comes right back to it when it changes to the A chord. Because again, C sharp is the third now of the A chord. You see how it's important to know what the arpeggios are, right? Okay. Comes back to it again and lets it down to the B when he gets to the E chord. Why? B is the fifth of E. Okay? Now we're back to F sharp. And we got this little lick here. So that's a cool little run. This is on the F sharp minor, sliding into C sharp, E the seventh, F sharp, A the minor third. Right? So again, those are all just chord tones, okay? Got that lick again, and then, okay, this is a cool lick. It's a sixth. Got an E note to a C sharp note. This is on the A chord. That's the fifth, and that's the third chord tones. Now, that's a classic Gilmore lick. It's bending the third of a major chord up a half step to the four and then bringing it back down. He does that all the time, and it's such a cool, melancholy sort of longing sound. Right? Bending an A up to a B to the E chord. Down to the A, down to G sharp for the E chord. G sharp's the third, right? Back to F sharp for the F sharp minor chord. And I like this one. And it just fades away. Great stuff. All right, let's go to the next part. So now we're just talking about an arpeggio here. F sharp, A, C sharp. He's literally just spelling out F sharp minor. Bending an E up a whole step to F sharp. Grabbing an A note, the minor third, back to F sharp. So, all together. Let's down to an E for the A chord. Now, that's a cool lick right there. So, right here, we're on an A note. We're bending a B note up to C sharp on the A chord. All right? So, all together. Down to the B for the E chord. Back to F sharp. Cool little blues lick there. All right? More bends. So F sharp minor, we're bending an A up to B, and then letting it down to A. Bending E up to F sharp, the root. I like that lick there. And again, it's all just coming back to bending the B up to C sharp on the A chord. And then, so this is on the E chord. And this is the first time we're emphasizing a non-chord tone. He's bending an E, he's bending a B up to C sharp. But the thing of it is, the payoff is then he lets it down to a chord tone, the B. Literally E major. G sharp, E, B. F sharp. So, that's the first half of the solo. That's as much as we'll do for now. The importance of chord tones in soloing and targeting certain notes and your touch on the instrument, your vibrato, your bends, and the use of space and just having patience to be melodic. Those are all the takeaways I get from when I listen to David Gilmour play. And I think it's a great lesson for all musicians, not just guitarists, to appreciate. So I hope you enjoyed today's breakdown. If you did, please consider subscribing to my channel for more videos like this to come. And thanks for watching.